He was very awe-inspiring when you saw him. He was monumental, grand in nature. His face was like a moon on Laylat al-Badr that had a light coming out of it like the moon on Laylat al-Badr. He was taller than a moderate build, but not exceedingly tall. Because both are, if you see somebody who's very tall, it's strange. Amongst even tall people, it seems strange. If you see somebody short, then also it's noticeable. But he was of a middle stature, inclining towards height, because everything about him was middle. Everything, even his physical description, his color was a middle color. Lam yakun amhaq. He wasn't pasty white and he wasn't black. He was of inclining toward light skin because of the racism in human beings. I mean, that's one of the hikmah of that. It has to do with stupidity in human beings in distinguishing between people because of color. He inclined towards light, but he wasn't pasty white. He was a color like what we call the harvest moon. And his hair was neither straight nor curly. It was wavy. It was middle. Everything about him was middle. He didn't speak slow and he didn't speak fast. He spoke in a moderate tone. His words were neither too short nor were they excessive, but they were always just right. When he spoke, people felt as if exactly the right amount of words were used. Everything about him was moderation. He had a full head, and his hair was wavy. If he parted it, then it parted. It never went past the lobes of his ears if he allowed it to go long, because sometimes he would cut it for ibadah, like the umrah or the hajj, when he shaved. But when he let it, it went to the lobes of his ears, and in some riwayah, just above the shoulder. And then he was azhar alone, which azhar alone is not white and it's not dark. It's a light skin, what we would call in English a ruddy complexion. Wasi' al-jabin. He had a large forehead, which in physiognomy traditionally was an indication of high quality. And then his eyebrows, they were full, and there was a slight space between them. And then he had a vein on his forehead that if he got upset, they could see the vein, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The upper part of his nose was aquiline, so he had a beautiful nose that had a bridging on the upper part. Lahu nurun ya'lu, and he had a light that came from that area of his face that was clearly discernible. Wa yahsibuhu.